Did you know that GMB categories are the most important element and the most vital ranking factor? Choose wrongly and you will exclude yourself from ranking. And remember, if it's not your business showing in the three pack, then it's your competitors.
Competitors.
In this video, I will show you exactly how to pick the best GMB categories tailored precisely for your business and your services. Let's make 2022 the year for your business.
I see it, I like it, I want it.
Hello, my name is Jasmine Placid. I am the founder of GMB Ranking Genius, where we help local businesses get to the top of Google, ranking the three pack and double and triple their business. So just how important are the GMB categories you select for your business? I've been helping businesses for the last couple of years, and I can see how frustrating it is not to be able to rank for a specific keyword. And most of the time, you don't rank because you have not selected that right GMB category. That's right. You may have everything correctly. You may have your GMB post. You may have your technical SEO right on point. You may have your website optimized. You may have everything. But if you don't have the right GMB category, there are no chances for you to rank. So in this video, I will make sure to teach you how to select the best GMB category so you can rank for that desired keyword. Are you ready? Let's get started. According to a Must study, the most important element and the most vital ranking factor are GMB categories and keywords and title. Choose wisely and you will position yourself better for search phrases, AKA your keywords and services you provide. Keep in mind, without the right GMB category, you will not rank in the three pack. When my clients come on board, that's one of the first things we do. We look at the set of keywords and we see what there is, their placement, their current placement on the three pack. Most often I realize that they're not ranking because they don't have the right GMB category. So this is crucial. Us professionals look at this very carefully, and I want you to take advantage of this opportunity and do it for your business. So how do you select the best GMB category tailored specifically for your businesses and for each and every one of your services? Well, first keep in mind that you will need a primary category and secondary categories. Google will always read your category first, then your GMB title. These are two very important elements, so let's pay close attention to them and start ranking in the three pack. Okay, so now that we understand that Google associates keywords with categories when trying to give you a search result, let's choose our primary category. I strongly suggest that you choose the keyword that is most profitable to you, your bread and butter type of service. You know which one I'm talking about, right? You're thinking about it right now. This is the keyword that brings you the most amount of money. Install and use the free Chrome extension GMB Everywhere. And now let me show you how to install and use the free Chrome extension GMB Everywhere. Let's go. So you go to a Chrome browser after you've installed your Chrome extension. You're going to type in your keyword, your most relevant keyword, and we're gonna look at some results together. Let's concentrate on the top of the results. Let's click on this very first one. And you will notice that the tool automatically will give you all of the categories associated with this keyword. However, let's just focus on the primary category, which is indicated with the little star. Now let's go to the second one, and we're gonna do the same. Let's look for all the categories, but more importantly, the primary category, and let's do the same with the third. We need to find a common denominator. We need to find a category that is the strongest one. And this is not only what your competitors are choosing as a primary category. What's most important is what Google is associating. And wants it to be for the primary category for this keyword. So now that you have selected your primary category, it's time to do some work. Go in the back of your GMB and check your primary category. I strongly suggest that you change it for the new found category, or you may already be well optimized for the category. If you're making a new GMB, do your homework beforehand so you're better prepared when Google asks you to enter a GMB category for your business. This will expedite your rankings. Secondary GMB categories or additional GMB categories. How do you go about finding your secondary GMB categories? Well, the way I do it with my clients, I ask my clients to give me a list of keywords focused on profitability and volume. Once I get this list of keywords, I run each and every one through this tool. I make sure that I find, in this case, the primary category associated with this keyword. I then take this primary category and I make it as a secondary category. You got it? Yes, you can do it. You can do it. This will help you determine what categories your competitors are using, but what's most important is what is Google associating with this keywords? What are the categories that Google is associating with this keywords? That's actually how you win the game. So make your list of keywords, find the most relevant category using this tool, make yourself a list, and then include it in your GMB dashboard as your secondary keywords. So how many GMB categories should you choose? Well, I recommend no more than 10. One being your primary category and the other 9 being your secondary category. Remember, we're choosing categories based on keywords. These are focused keywords and categories. You think of a keyword first and then you find the dominant category associated with that keyword and you choose accordingly. Got it? Make a category audit if you see a drop in your rankings. As you know, Google Maps allows public users to suggest edits. They don't always go through, but if the user has a high trust level with Google, it may just go through. So if you ever see that you dropped in rankings and you can't explain why, it's important that at least every month you check your GMB categories just to make sure no one has suggested an edit. And this is how you would notice a user suggested an edit. So step one, choose your primary category based on your most profitable keyword. Step two, choose your secondary categories based on services you provide, on keywords you want to be found for. Focus on profitability and volume, 10 is a max, choose wisely. Step three, make a category audit as part of your routine. So now I want to hear from you. Do you have a strategy in place to grow your business in 2022? Leave a comment down below and let me know. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more content like this. Presentations day, or are they really vital for Google Pack rankings? Find out all about citations in this next video. I'll see you there.